Assalamu alaikum, dear cadets. Dear cadets, I hope you will be safe and sound with your families at your houses. Dear cadets, today we are going to start our next chapter, second chapter of the biology of class 9. Dear cadets, the second chapter is solving a biological problem. Dear cadets, in this chapter, we will discuss that if a biologist faces a problem in the field of biology, then how he solves that problem. So, to solve that problem, what procedure is applied? So, let's start. Because science is the systematic knowledge derived from the observations and experimentation. Absolutely. Dear cadets, we know that science is a knowledge which is based on the observations, and then in the light of the observations, biologists perform experiments. Scientists perform experiments, and then they acknowledge something. These experiments are carried out to determine the principles about how nature operates. To perform different experiments, it is necessary, because after experimentation, we can get knowledge about the processes of the nature, about the phenomena of the nature. Dear cadets, scientist, he may be a biologist, physicist, or chemist. They also, all of them, they face different problems in their own fields. They all have the same method of solving the problem, that is known, and in the field of biology, that problem is known, the method of solving problem is known as biological method. Dear cadets, questions about the living things have provided problems that man has investigated to aid his own survival and to satisfy his desire to know. The scientific method in which biological problems are solved is termed as biological method. Dear cadets, here we can define as a biological method as the scientific method. Scientific method means an organized method. The scientific method in which biological problems are solved is known as biological method. It consists of steps a biologist adopts in order to solve a biological problem. Dear cadets, a biological method has played an important part in scientific research for almost 500 years. From Galileo's experiment in 1590s to current research, the biological method has contributed to the advancements in medicine, ecology, technology, etc. Biological method also ensures the quality of the data for public use. Dear cadets, if we perform any task, especially a task which is related to solving problem, it is very essential to solve a problem in an organized way, not in a random way. If we select an organized way, organized method to solve any problem, then we will get very accurate data about that problem. Dear cadets, biological problem, hypothesis, detection and experiments. These are the main steps of the biological method. In biology, like other sciences, new things are being discovered and long-held theories are being modified or replaced with the better ones. As more data knowledge is accumulated, this happens when biologists recognize some biological problem and go for its solution. In solving problem, biologists take following steps. What are the steps? Recognition of the biological problem. It is the first step of the biological method. First of all, biologists recognize the biological problem. Second step is observation. It means to make observation about the specific problem. Third step is hypothesis formulation. Next, fourth step is deduction. Deduction means the conclusion, the consequences, the results of the hypothesis. Next, fifth, experimentation. Sixth step is summarization of the results. In the result, we create tables, graphics, etc. And the last and seventh step of the biological method is reporting the results. After experimentation, we summarize the results. And after summarization of the results, the biologists report their results in magazines, in conferences, in meetings, in journals. Now we will discuss these steps in detail. Dear cadets, first step, recognition of the biological problem. Dear cadets, biologists go for adopting biological method when they encounter some biological problem. A biological problem is a question related to the living organism that is either asked by someone or comes in biologist mind by himself. Dear cadets, first step is recognition of a biological problem. Matlab ke ek biological problem, ek masla jo hai, ek question hai, jo issue hai, face ho raha hai, usko sabse pehle recognize karna hai ke wo asal mein kya issue hai, what type of issue is being faced. So first step is recognition. Next, observation. Dear cadets, as the first step in the solving problem, biologist recalls previous observations or makes new ones. Observations are made with five senses of the vision, hearing, taste, smell and touch. Observation may be both qualitative and quantitative. Because observations are very necessary to solve a biological problem. The observer will get observation from the previous knowledge, from the other scientists, other biologists or other people, the previous people, and he may make the new observation in the current situation. And this observation may be qualitative and quantitative. These are the two types of the observation. Quantitative observations are considered more accurate than qualitative because the quantitative observations are invariable. They do not vary. They do not change. They are invariable and measurable. They can be measured and can be recorded in terms of number. So it is more accurate, most reliable type of observation, quantitative. The observation which is invariable, measurable and can be recorded in terms of numbers is known as quantitative observation. Next, qualitative observation. Dear cadets, Qualitative observation is the observation which can which may vary, which is variable and unmeasurable, and cannot be recorded in term of number. Next, we will discuss the examples of these observation. Qualitative observation. We have an example: the freezing point of water is colder than the boiling point. Now, we cannot measure in this term. We are not going to measure. We don't know how much. We know that water is colder than boiling point. Sorry, freezing point is colder than boiling point, but we do not know how much it is colder. So it is a qualitative. We cannot measure. We cannot. It may vary. The cold percentage may be vary. May be increase. May be decrease. Next, quantitative. If we look at in a quantitative observation, the freezing point of water 0 degrees centigrade and boiling point is 100 degrees centigrade. Now we have the specific digits, specific numbers. Now it is more accurate, more reliable and measurable. Another example: a liter of water is heavier than a liter of ethanol. A liter of water is heavier than a liter of ethanol, but we don't know how much it is heavier. In quantitative term, a liter of water weighs 1000 grams. A liter of water has 1000 grams, but a liter of ethanol has 789 grams. So there is a difference. We can record them in term of number. Observation also include reading and studying what others have done in the past, because scientific knowledge is ever growing. So we can make observation by studying the previous books and journals, articles. Next, dear cadets, we have the formulation of hypothesis. Dear cadets, observation do not become scientific observation until they are organized and related to the question. You get it? Just observation is not more reliable. Observation are become scientific and organized when they are organized and they are being related. They are related to a question. Well, just organized is and others observation into data form and construct a statement that may prove to be the answer of the biological problem under study. Dear cadets, the biologist organized observation and they form a statement. They form a specific statement in the light of the observation, and that statement that statement may provide answer to the specific question. It may be next. We can define hypothesis as the tentative explanation of the observations is called hypothesis. The tentative explanation of the observation. It means that hypothesis is the explanation of the observation. But what kind of observation? Tentative explanation. Tentative means experimental. मतलब क्या? Observation को जब हम experiments में लेके आने की कोशिश करते हैं या इस काबिल बनाते हैं कि वो हम उसको एक्सपेरिमेंट की फॉर्म में बयान कर सकें, तो उस वक्त हम ऑब्जर्वेशन को हाइपोथेसिस कहते हैं. इट मे बी डिफाइंड एज ए प्रोपोजिशन दैट माइट बी ट्रू. अ हाइपोथेसिस शुड हैव द फॉलोइंग कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स. Following now we will discuss the characteristics of the hypothesis. Number one is it should be a general statement. A hypothesis should be a general statement. It should be a tentative idea. Tentative idea means that we can perform experiment about that idea. It should be agree with available observation. It should be kept as simple as possible. Hypothesis should be simple. It should be testable and potentially falsifiable. A hypothesis should be in a form, in a pattern that we can test that hypothesis, and there should be a potential, there should be an ability in a hypothesis to be false. A hypothesis should not be always right. It is not necessary that a hypothesis will always be right. It may be false. So, I think, dear cadets, it's enough for today. I hope you will prepare your lecture and this lecture with full zeal and zest. Stay blessed. Allah Hafiz.